A galaxy, as you may already know, is a massive collection in the billions of stars, planets, dust, and gas. We live on planet Earth, which is in one of the many solar systems located in a galaxy called the Milky Way. Like our home galaxy, there are many other galaxies out there in the universe. The Andromeda Galaxy, for example, is the closest major galaxy to our home galaxy. Despite being a whopping 2.5 million light years away, Andromeda is so big that it's the most distant thing humans can see with the naked eye. Now, it's important to note that Andromeda is not the closest galaxy to us. There are actually several minor galaxies that lie much closer to us than the Andromeda Galaxy. However, Andromeda is the closest large spiral galaxy. Think about this for a moment. Andromeda is 2.5 million light years away. For those who don't know, a light year is the total distance light can travel in 1 year. And light moves incredibly fast, 300 million meters per second, or 186,282 miles per second. This gives you a rough estimate of how mind-bogglingly far away Andromeda truly is. Despite that mammoth distance, we can still see it in the night sky, provided you're at exactly the right place at just the right time. Given this, it seems odd that we can't see planets that are just a few light years away from Earth. In fact, we can barely see the planets in our own solar system. So, why can we see far-off galaxies, despite their extreme distance? There are two main reasons. Firstly, galaxies are huge. Our Milky Way roughly consists of 100 billion stars, and is about 100,000 light-years across. Andromeda, however, is even larger, a whopping 220,000 light-years wide. The closest known galaxy to Earth is the Canis Major Dwarf Galaxy, sitting at 25,000 light-years, or nearly 236 quadrillion kilometers from our Sun. After that comes the Sagittarius Dwarf Elliptical Galaxy, which is 70,000 light-years, or 662 quadrillion kilometers from our Sun. As you can imagine, galaxies are very big, which is why we can still see them from Earth. The second reason for their visibility is that galaxies are bright. Thanks to the billions upon billions of stars they contain, galaxies are extremely bright and shiny, making them visible in our night sky. One thing we often tend to overlook while talking about planets and galaxies together is how ridiculously small planets are in comparison to galaxies. If a galaxy were a basketball, then a planet would be a million times smaller than a single speck of dust clinging to that basketball. In fact, it would be even smaller than that. We are unable to see planets outside our solar system just a few light years away because planets are simply too small to be observed at such a distance. In addition to their size, planets are not bright. They merely reflect the light that falls on their surface, and that light is too dim to be observed from Earth. This is why we're unable to see planets outside of our solar system. Think of it this way. You can easily see a hill that looms 10 or 15 kilometers away from your house, but can you see a grain of sugar lying just a few feet away? Probably not. In much the same way, a distant galaxy is visible to us with the naked eye, but a nearby planet isn't visible at all, since the latter is far too tiny and much too dim to be observed from our location. Fortunately, we can see planets much closer to home, such as those in our own solar system. These planets are visible at different times of the year and in different locations of the sky, depending on where you live. This captivating contrast between the visibility of galaxies and planets highlights the vastness of our universe and inspires us to continue exploring and understanding the cosmos, one celestial body at a time. If you enjoyed this video, we'd love to hear from you in the comments section. Your feedback not only supports us, but also helps our channel reach more viewers and continue to grow.